Oh, this is that one guy.
Pepe Aguilar.
His daughter and son. Have you ever seen him?
No.
They're pretty good singers, too.
El acero apresta de ébrido y retiene en su centro la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón.
There's only one national anthem, because they're both from Mexico.
Yeah, I think so.
Al sonoro rugir del cañón. Signo patria, tu sienes de oliva.
Trump's gonna come out.
Get this
shit
out
of here. Suelo,
pienso patria querida, que el cielo un soldado en cada hijo te dio. Un soldado en cada hijo te dio. Mexicanos al grito de guerra, el acero apresta y el bridón, y retiembla en su centro la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Y retiembla en su centro la tierra al sonoro.
Can you see my dawn's early light? Much so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through
fight.
Oh, she was good. 60 seconds,
right?
Calm down, Kim K.
Hola, hierbas.
Canelo's 10 pounds heavier than he usually fights, huh?
Yeah.
What? No, I'm coming.
His father, much more than a boxing star in Mexico, their ultimate cultural icon. But yet some Mexican fans who adored his father have never embraced Julio Jr. because they don't see in him the same personality. Before determining that the moment will be right for him to come to the ring. Behind him, they're cheering already.
There's a lot of Spanish people with red hair.
Above the screen.
What's going on?
Nothing changes the expression on that face.
Nothing at all, Jimmy. He's like a baby-faced assassin, you know? He keeps the same attitude no matter what's going on, no matter how rough the fight gets.
Yesterday, in some of the sports books in Vegas. The odds favoring Alvarez were...
Fighting out of the blue corner with his trainer Nacho Beristain.
Nacho!
He's wearing white and weighed in officially at 164 pounds. 15 victories, including 52 wins by knockout with two defeats and one draw. Presenting the former middleweight champion of the world, Damas y Caballeros, el ex campeón del mundo, el ex guerrero Machando de Curio.
I bet you if he fought Mayweather now, he'd beat the little man. All the experience in the game.
Mexican show troop fighters would prove they belong. Chavez Jr. has not yet done that. Witness tonight to prove it. Do it again if Chavez is the best version of himself.
Herrera Morales pulled the bands three times. Will this be the first meeting between Canelo and Chavez? Or the only meeting between
them? That was big enough.
The nature of the combat will probably determine it.
Way taller.
Chavez boxing in the middle of the ring, as Nacho Beristain said, would be the strategy early. I don't know if that's the wisest thing for him, Roy.
I don't think he's going to box in the middle of the ring, Max. He's kind of circling, but he's not really giving up a lot of ground. He's not going backwards. He's going around. He's circling.
Chavez got in an uppercut.
Hard hook to the body from Chavez.
That's what you want to see.
You would think for Chavez to really impose himself in this fight, he has to pull Canelo and use his size and weight.
Canelo threw his own left hook to the body moments ago. Now right hand across the top. Canelo's conventional weaponry scoring early against Julio Cesar Chavez.
Well, Canelo is short, he's dialed in. Doing a good jab, not open to the short guy, out jab the taller guy. But right now he's doing a good job of out jabbing Chavez Jr.
Hard to imagine Chavez winning a boxing skills match in the middle of the ring against Canelo. The sharper, more active, more accurate fighter.
Canelo seems to be making that statement right now. He can't box with me.
Ooh.
Good jab by Canelo.
So quick. Delivers it. Snappily. Economical motion. Nothing's wasted.
Okay.
Right hand on the top for Canelo. He's gotten off to a very good start in the fight.
Okay. He's moving his back
too. Chavez is a pressure fighter. Sometimes they take a couple rounds to really get going.
Gotta make sure he's not caught by anything big that sends him to the floor early. That's the danger of fighting a guy as sharp as Canelo is.
Interesting game when they came together. Canelo used his leverage as a shorter fighter to push Chavez back.
3 minutes have gone by pretty fast. And so far, Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. has landed some punches, but nothing really significant.
I'm moving this back.
In great condition, both guys came in operating to that degree.
Canelo landed 13 punches in the first round. Chavez landed only 4 by CompuBox count. Canelo pretty much double of Chavez in punches thrown. 31-16. That's round number 2.
So far, Chavez thinking, staying true to what Nacho Beristain, his trainer, his new trainer, he said in the lead up to the fight that he wants him at a distance early. I don't know if that's wise strategy, Roy. Canelo likes his opponent to come to him, so that's playing into his hands as Chavez does, but just because the guy's a fastball hitter,
Well, this looks a lot like the early stages of Sergio Martinez against Julio Cesar Chavez. It's a rout in Canelo's favor. But you know what happened in that fight? Where Chavez hung around long enough to suddenly make his big hunting rounds along the club and almost knocked Martinez out. So you can never completely count him out of the fight. But Canelo is having his way in the first two rounds so far.
Chavez, of course, has done his best work. He's thrown the hook to the body.
Canelo is going to start early if he's sharp or got early because he's been so. We expect him to come out and have the advantage over.
Left hook lands for Chavez.
That's true. Chavez ain't using
hand for Chavez.
He's hiding his distance, man.
And here is Chavez's fight. As he tries to go short, Canelo also feels very comfortable countering in that position, but that's where Chavez does his best work.
Punch combination for Canelo and another good uppercut for the left hand as he steps inside.
He's
ducking right into those uppercuts.
Yes, he is.
He stands in the center of the ring and tries to box with Canelo. He's got to get him to the ropes.
Got to move that hand left and right. He can't leave right there down the middle so that shit Canelo can hit him with those uppercuts.
Chavez shows no inclination to do something to stop Canelo from landing a jab. Canelo's just stepping forward and back with jabs and uppercuts and landing a lot of shots.
Canelo getting very confident now.
And it's Canelo controlling the middle of the ring and forcing Chavez along the perimeter. Certainly not a winning strategy for Chavez, you wouldn't think.
He's got to try to put Canelo's back against the ropes. What he was ultimately able to do against Martinez, and he landed his power shots there. He'll be next.
And Canelo inflicted a lot of pain on Chavez that second round. Mainly those
the first two rounds, Canelo landed 22 power shots, 11 out missed to the body of Chavez.
Canelo wants his opponent to come at him so he can use his combinations to counter. But that's also Chavez's best chance. That's why the matchup on paper is so good. Because their strengths play into each other. Chavez is not a very sharp boxer, but he's a good, strong inside brawler, especially for a tall guy. And that's where his fight should be.
Most ringside experts shook their heads in amusement, reading quotes from Chavez's camp, and particularly from trainer Nacho Berastain, saying that he should stand up on his feet, box from the perimeter, use his length and height, and try to win a boxing match against Canelo. Most boxing experts thought smoke, it couldn't possibly be true, or it's cool to keep that plan. It is a one-way path to oblivion.
And right now it seems almost foolish.
And then the thought was also that once he gets his bell rung, Chavez will go back to what he does, which is brawling. And he just got his bell rung. Let's see what happens.
Alvarez blocking punches with his gloves and then firing back, having everything his way. Get way through round three.
Alvarez blocking punches with his face and his body. That blood on Chavez's right eye.
Oh, no, they just worked it. No blood yet, but there's a help. And a black eye started to fall.
Hard right hand.
Yeah.
He never overloads a punch, Roy.
Right?
He wants to land at his face.
Very efficient, Jim. Blood at the nose now, Max.
There's been no turning point.
We got to find this
now
player.
We got a fight.
He's got a good shot by Chavez.
Chavez sticks in a couple of hard shots. And he's got Canelo's back to the ropes. And Canelo fights his way off the ropes.
He's been grabbing from the distance and set him up. Not trying to ball with him.
As Chavez already given up his best chance to win, which is to jump on Canelo early and let him feel the size difference. Instead, he's allowed Canelo, or Canelo's impulsed himself, and it's boxing skills.
When you're punching this sharp, it's not really much size difference involved.
Today in Chavez's corner, throw more punches. And still, to this point, Canelo Alvarez has not yet sat down between rounds. He's still standing in his corner. Chavez is sitting on the stool now. Harold Letterman had to score the first three rounds.
Okay, Jim, I got a 3-0, 30-27, Canelo Alvarez. I gotta tell you, Jim, this kid is a pretty boxer. Look at this. Hooks, jabs, he doubles punches, he triples punches. Yeah, I mean, he's in the ring, and he's backing him up constantly. He's got him bleeding from the nose. Got him bleeding from the eyes. Hitting him with uppercuts. What else can he do? He's fighting a very good fight. 3-0 Canelo Alvarez.
That's too bad.
Yeah. Yeah,
he's back. I mean, he's not using his full
his power that he has.
His full tools, man. Yeah. Like kinda...
And if he's not going to use his size advantage on the inside, it will not be a competitive fight. It has not been so far.
I'm wondering if it was a good idea to make that. I'm wondering if it might not have been a better idea to pay a couple of $1 million to come in over 166. At least he might have disturbed some of Canelo's sleep. Uppercut. After the left hook to the body. Chavez is putting punches together.
Oh.
Right hand upstairs. Harold Letterman described it so well.
He's not fighting back. I don't know what the
he's
fuck,
not.
Man.
He's just. He's saying, "I'm hit him right."
Yeah. What the fuck is that?
This is thus far not one of the great all Mexican fights, but it's maybe one of the great all Mexican beatdowns.
Good body shot.
Yep, that really hurts.
The opposition, you have to call it a great performance by Canelo, who is thoroughly under control and doing everything he wants to do.
Maybe he's already like stunned and dazed or something.
What a crowd. This crowd is making about as much noise inside this arena as 90,000 people made at Wembley.
Waiting for that one shot.
Canelo, you look on his face right now and see. Boy, he doesn't respect Chavez. He doesn't think Chavez has any big points.
He's got total confidence.
And Chavez has given him no reason to respect him. He has.
We'll see if he makes it for each round.
Canelo is averaging 21 punches landed per round. Again, as Max Kellerman said, it's a mismatch.
So let him get tired.
And again, Chavez starts by circling on the outside of the ring.
Target practice.
Canelo doing whatever he wants.
Boy, is it fair to say Canelo's sparring sessions may have been more taxing than this?
No, I don't think they are more taxing because you don't have an audience in sparring sessions. But, I mean, it could have been more difficult, but this crowd takes a lot out of you. People don't understand that. That's why some guys can perform in the gym. That's why you have things such as gym fighting, with right hands and all that. But when you have a crowd to fight in front of, this crowd drains you. So no way that sparring is more taxing than this.
Tell you something else. Canelo claims that there's no extra animosity against Chavez. Just more intensity, maybe, because of the Mexican rivalry. But Chavez has said that he doesn't think that Canelo is best represented Mexican boxing. And the look on Canelo's face here, guys, looks to me like he's really enjoying handing out this punishment.
He's really putting a bang on Chavez right now.
And here, Chavez has an opportunity. Canelo is near the ropes. Pull him back to the ropes and throw punches. His only chance.
He seems to have bought into the notion that he can box with Canelo, and nothing could be further from the truth. Less than a minute to go in round number five. Nothing has changed. It's been a punishing first 2 minutes of the round for Chavez Jr.
Chavez was frittering away the prime of his career. Canelo has been in with not just the mega fights with Mayweather and Cotto, but tough fights against contenders you ordinarily wouldn't want to fight on your way up. Austin Trout, Eris Landy, Lara. Canelo stayed busy. He's treated his career very seriously, and you're seeing that here tonight.
This is only the fight for Chavez since the landing an average of 5 out of 19 punches per round. In his previous 8 fights, the average was 16 out of 40. Those opponents were not Canelo Alvarez. You see the number for total punches landed at the bottom of the screen. Whether Canelo had an intention to come in here and embarrass Chavez Jr. or not, that's what's happening so far.
Yeah. Although Chavez had those late rounds near heroics against Sergio Martinez, he wasn't getting pounded this consistently by power shots throughout by an aggressive fighter. He was the one chasing Martinez around.
And I don't think Martinez was as heavy a puncher as Canelo Alvarez.
The thing that you see in the beginning of every round tells you the whole story before the round starts, the posture. When Chavez backs up and circles, it means he's conceding already.
I just learned that between rounds, Kenny Bayless visited the corner of Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. and told Chavez and Nacho Barros, saying, quote, you've got to show me something. In other words, Bayless is already of a mind that he's not going to let this continue indefinitely the way it's going right now.
Even right there, Chavez throws a 1-2, and he waits and looks and doesn't follow, doesn't attempt to impose his strength. And by the way, guys, maybe he's not physically stronger. Canelo has the leverage of the shorter man and looks very strong in that.
Well, Nacho Beristain urgently pleaded with Chavez Jr. between rounds to show the punches, but he isn't doing it.
The only thing you don't like, I didn't like what I saw in between rounds, champ, was that you never heard Chavez say anything back.
And he looked very discouraged.
And I hate when I don't hear my father talk back to me. I always ask him right away, how you feeling? What's wrong?
Here's where Chavez needs to be.
It's in the mouth.
And he cannot allow Canelo's sharp counters, which are sure to come, to discourage him. He must stay right there. Not really just to take those 2 steps back.
It looks as though Canelo, the counterpuncher, has invited Chavez into this position, hoping that he's going to throw some shots and give him a chance to fire back with a counter that would hurt him.
But that's okay. It may hit some Chavez's demise. It may lead to a knockout earlier than it would otherwise come. But it also gives Chavez his only chance to win.
Only chance.
Chavez begins to loosen up and throw a little bit. Left and right to the body, both of them partially blocked by Canelo's elbow.
And it shows you Chavez's mentality. Immediately takes 3 steps back, and it's in the middle of the ring again.
Can't do it.
This has become a showcase for Canelo Alvarez's outstanding skill set.
It's the same mistake we saw Canelo make against Floyd Mayweather. He went out and tried to box the boxer. You can't do that.
To respond to Nacho Beristain's instructions, I have an athlete proof.
Okay, so now you have a 6-0, 60-54, Canelo Alvarez. Not only is he beating the heck out of the guy, he throws combinations, he throws hard jabs, it's just unbelievable. What gets me about Chavez is why in heaven's name doesn't somebody tell him to go forward? I think he just backs up and backs up and backs up and gets beat up. You think if he went forward, he might be able to hurt Canelo. But he's not. He just keeps backing up. 6-0, Canelo Alvarez.
Guys, the last significant fight that Chavez had was against Fanfara.
Frustrating because the guy is freaking out.
That was in a heavier weight division. So the thought was,
he's got talent, man.
He's not using it.
Yeah, for some reason, he's just not throwing punches. I don't know why.
It's a mismatch.
Oh, no.
That was one of the closest things we've seen for Chavez 2 4-punch combinations in a row that drove Chavez back into the center of the ring.
And probably Chavez needs to come right back off of those rallies and come up with a rally of his own, but he's not. So that means he's not even trying to compete when he's not doing that. You have to compete. So you gotta answer those type of punches back right there. If you're not answering those type of punches back, you're not competing. That's a good combination.
Somewhere there's an avid Chavez lover who's saying, no, wait until the middle of round 11. That's when he gets going.
Well, they're not necessarily wrong about that, but you're seeing the difference here between a guy who, yes, he's been a good fighter, Chavez, but let's be honest, there was most of the interest was generated by his father's name. And then he became a good fighter on top of that. Canelo Alvarez created his own career as a 15-year-old fighting grown men in Mexico, becoming a YouTube sensation and packing places in Mexico before coming here and fighting all the top fighters and acquitting himself so well.
Chavez has to attack him right back right then if he wants to have a chance to win the fight. If he doesn't do that, he has no chance because Canelo is sharp, Canelo is dived in, Canelo is going up and down, Canelo is fighting a very good fight here.
A lot of people thought it was a mistake for Canelo Alvarez to take a fight with Floyd Mayweather when he was clearly too young and too inexperienced to deal with the great fighter. But as a piece of business, it turned out to be genius. It gave him a big name here in the United States. Without his having fought a large number of fights here, it set him up to become what he is right now. The biggest monetary news for Chavez is most busy round of the fight. He landed 9 out of 42 punches. Both of those numbers are his high for the fight so far. However, Canelo landed 18 of 57, and a lot of the 18 were those sharp, hard power shots like you saw in the replay.
But Chavez had to reach for greatness tonight to compete with Canelo. And he hasn't done it, and maybe he hasn't been prepared in recent years, given the way his career has gone, to do it. He's going to need some late-round thunder, like you mentioned, against Sergio Martinez to salvage anything here tonight, Jim. And that's if he gets to the 11th or 12th round.
I might not have the good fortune of seeing Chavez tear his right knee up while falling to the canvas, as Martinez did that night.
Here, now he's doing some good work, Chavez. And when Canelo inevitably counters what Chavez
right
do, back up and give him room or stay on his chest.
He needs to stay on his chest, but he's not doing that.
Too cautious. Chavez needs to sell out.
That's how, like, all he's screaming for Javi when he was like, come on, Javi!
No, I just wanted to talk about
the point about Chavez's performance is that lack of resolve to get on Canelo's chest and stay there. He seems resigned to take the beating.
He proclaimed that he wanted the fight. He expressed great desire. He got himself into what looked like his best condition ever. He made weight, shocking a lot of ring critics, including myself, who didn't think that he would do that. He brought the odds down by doing so, but he's getting whipped by a superior fight with better skills.
And Canelo really teeing off right now.
His multiple skills, his combination punching, his general ring command. Of course, Julio Cesar Chavez to fight the way he wants to fight. Center of the ring and embarrassed him over and over and over with repeated combinations, slingshots, landing upstairs and downstairs as he's doing right now.
Chavez has something dramatic up his sleeve, where this fight will be seen as an object lesson on wishful thinking on the part of the public, on essentially a fighter being able to perpetrate a fraud on the public by not earning his way to the fight.
Here comes Chavez. Set out. Have to throw caution to the wind now. Only 4 rounds to go.
To know the great Mexican rivals like Ruben Olivares and Chucho Castillo earned their way to the fight, the trilogy with each other, and Raul Marquez and Vasquez earned their way to those spots. Canelo has earned his way here, and Chavez has largely traded on his name. And he needs to fight for his own name here, show us something in the last couple rounds.
Those were some of Chavez's best shots of the fight.
He didn't show nothing. I mean, he was fighting the guy.
By answering back and driving him.
He's losing, man.
He's not Canelo. He is all colors. He's not showing up. You want to throw low, throw low. He ought to come anyway. He's fully confident at this point in the fight.
Well, yeah, it makes Canelo look bad. Because if it goes to 4-12, you know, it's going to be like, he's still taking him out.
Canelo, right? Whenever he wants to use it,
he's not allowed Cesar Chavez to just sit there and pose right in front of him like other fighters do. See right there? Watch him throw uppercuts. Anytime he wants to make Cesar Chavez get out of there, he throws uppercuts right there in the middle. And Chavez is not comfortable with that shot being hit to the nose.
And also, Chavez here is doing some good work. Yep. But he's so easily discouraged and driven back.
Because he's getting hit with hard shots right down the middle, be it the uppercut or the jab. Like this.
First, you're going to get hit when you got Canelo on the ropes. Canelo wants you to put him on the ropes so he can counter. You have to know that going into the fight.
People say speed is power. Accuracy is power, too. Canelo learned that against Floyd Mayweather. And if you get hit over and over in the mouth or the nose, you don't have to be getting hit hard to get tired of it, to not want it anymore, to back away from it. And Canelo is using his superior accuracy to continue making the point to Chavez. I can hit you as Canelo.
Yeah, it's so weird that, just like you said, he didn't really show up to win.
He's just trying to make the 12 rounds, but say that he went the distance with him.
Uh-huh.
He knocked me out.
Yeah.
As Gennady turns to the camera and gives us a smile and a little dip.
That's like a son of a bitch smile.
Who's that?
I don't know who that is, but their face is too tight to smile.
Come on, this is the island, Julio. Gotta let go, Julio. Take your hands off. That's your way.
Slow
punches. The
water. Yeah. Well, his interview, he was saying that he never grew up as a normal kid. He always, since he was a junior, so his dad tried showing him, I have to be good with my dad.
Canelo can't hurt him.
One round to go.
Yeah, that's kind of whack.
That's Billy didn't have to fucking pay 70 fucking bucks.
But if he did, either way, it lasted.
Yeah, it did last 12 rounds.
So I guess he gets your money's worth, sort of.
Yeah.
Sort of, but if they're not fighting like this guy.
I mean, Canelo's putting it down.
He's just getting his ass beat, I think. I think at a certain point, it's like.
Maybe his dad realized you're just a brat, you're not gonna, you know, just fucking lose. You're gonna get money to win this in Mexico. Doesn't matter. Stay.
11 rounds. You gotta win this one, and that's it. Don't get crazy. Careful. You have to hit your own fight. Don't go forward.
This is the last round, right?
Yeah. Woo! Doing good. Good jab. A lot of damn jab. And watch that race. Watch that race. One round.
Round 12. I'm going to sleep in Cuba. Chavez would have to get lucky. And, in boxing, the
bills. Is that cool with this?
Craft is key. And those people understood this fight from the beginning and were serious about it. They've been on the same train all the way. There's no way Chavez can beat Canelo given the difference in the level of skill.
And you get out what you put in. You know, Andre Ward, Vasily Lomachenko, Gennady Golovkin, Canelo Alvarez. You talk about the top of the sport. These guys are all extremely serious competitive athletes who respect themselves and respect the sport and give themselves the best chance to be great. And that is not what Chavez Jr. has done.
With no nonsense between fights, no headlines for things that take place outside the ring. That generally is what defines the top guys who Max Kellerman just named.
Kovalev, Chocolatito.
Chavez Jr. has been exactly the opposite. So at the end of the day, after years of discussion,
Ten seconds left.
What some thought would never happen. Getting them into the ring together. It became an exhibition.
That was
an
exhibition
of all the skills that get into our players. And Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. has never had.
Whack.
In retrospect, it was always going to be an exhibition.
Of course, there's a fucking Mayweather. I mean,
but you couldn't tell that to the nation of Mexico, which framed it. Got it, and now can talk about it for 48 hours before the Canelo fans.
One away, all to the winner by unanimous decision. De Guadalajara, Jalisco, Saúl Canelo
numbers in the fight. Canelo Alvarez landing 157 more punches than Julio Cesar Chavez Jr., landing more punches in every round, landing at a 38% connect percentage, which is high, doubling the number of punches that Chavez threw, tripling the number of punches that Chavez landed. How many more ways can we say? It's a one-sided wipeout. Power punches. Nearly tripling Chavez Jr. in terms of the number of power punches thrown. Nearly, or ever landed. Nearly doubling the number that he threw. And landing at a 43% connect percentage, which is going to win you most fights against any opposition.